What's up, everybody? My name is Jared with Final Cut Pro Help. I wanted to bring this quick tutorial to you to show you how to create what we see here on the screen, which is comparing two projects side by side. I have one project on the left that has a red tint across the entire project, and then the original on the right, which has no tint at all, just so you can see the differences here. But you could do this with any versions of projects, any ones that you want to compare there. So yeah, we're going to jump into Final Cut Pro here, and if you have a different interface, go ahead and hit Command 0 on the keyboard to reset back to the default interface. And I'm going to hide the library sidebar here on the left by clicking this button in the upper left corner. And I'm going to do a search through my clips here for the word clip. This is just going to narrow it down because I added keywords on these projects so we can see just the few projects that I'm working with here. So you'll notice here project A has an adjustment layer on it with the red tint, and project B is the original without that tint. And I want to compare these two projects side by side. So to do that, I'm going to first go into project A. I'm going to click on any clip in the project and use Command A to select all of those clips. And then I'm going to group them into a compound clip using Option G on the keyboard. This is just going to be called Project A, Final Cut Pro Help Clip. Totally fine. You can name it something different if you want to. Then I'm going to do the same thing inside of Project B. Click on it, click on any clip in it to select one, use Command A to select them, and Option G to group those into a compound clip. All right, so we have two compound clips with those projects. You'll notice them here inside of the browser because I searched the word clip, they're showing up there. So now to actually compare them side by side, I need to create a new project using Command N. And this is going to be our comparison project. You can again name it anything you want, but please don't leave it as untitled project. You want to keep things organized. So I'm going to just put project A and B here. And click OK to create that project. It's of course empty, so now we can add our two compound clips to it. So I can select project A and just drag that down onto the primary storyline. And then I'm going to drag down B, but I'm going to connect it to that primary storyline at the top here. So now I have both projects inside of a new project here. And you'll notice then up here in the viewer, we only see project B right now. So with it selected, I'm going to scale it down by about 50%, right? So we want it to be by half. And then you can take your X position and move this over to the right side here. And then we'll do the same thing with project A. With that one selected, I can scale it down by 50%. And I'm using the inspector over on the right side here just to drag these and move them around, put them side by side. You can do it that way, or you can go in and hit the transform tool and then manually drag it where you want to put it. Totally up to you which way you want to do that there. And that is really about it. We now have those two projects side by side, and we can skim through them and see them, and they are there ready to go. Now, that may be it depending on how you've edited your project, but looking at my project here, if I skim through it, you'll notice I run into an issue with this clip here where all of a sudden this clip jumps out. It's much larger than the other ones. If you run into this, it's simply because a transform was done on this bird clip here. And you'll notice it's not happening in project A, but it is happening in project B. And that's because project A has an adjustment layer added to it. So to fix these kind of issues, just go into the project where it's an issue. In this case, project B, I can double click on it. It's a compound clip, so it's going to open it up. I can go up to my effects here, and I have my adjustment layer, which you can download from the website if you need this. And I'll just drag this on top of the project and extend it the entire length of the project. That way, anywhere where there might be transforms happening, this will just crop them all to fit inside of that area. And then I'm going to use the timeline history back button here to go back into my comparison. And you'll notice that's now fixed. Those clips are all going to be resized and essentially cropped to fit into that area there. Now also, remember, these are compound clips. So if I go back to project B, the original project here, and double click on it, you'll see that it's the compound clip and it has that adjustment layer added to it. So any edits that you make inside of these compound clips, whether it be the Project A compound clip or Project B, are going to be reflected in our comparison Project A and B. So that's kind of nice. You can set this up once, and then it's there as you're editing both of your projects. You have that comparison ready to go. At any time, if you're done with this and you don't need this comparison anymore, you can select the project and use Command Delete to delete it. You can go into Project A, select your compound clip, and you can actually break apart these clip items either by selecting it and using Shift Command G, or when you're in a project, if you have that compound clip selected, you can go up to the clip menu and use Break Apart Clip Items. So that's how you take two projects and compare them side by side. So just to review, the steps are opening the first project, selecting all using Command A or Edit Select All, then group all of those clips using Option G to create a new compound clip. Everything will be grouped together in that new clip. Repeat those steps for the second project, open Project B, Command A to select all, Option G to group them into a compound clip. And now you have your two compound clips. So create a new project using Command N, and then add both projects' compound clips to that new project and use the transform tool or the inspector to resize them so they are side by side. I hope this helped. If you have any questions, you can email finalcutprohelp@anawesomeguide.com or reach out on Instagram @finalcutprohelp.